As an American Indian and organizer of powwows, Robbie Swift understands the role tobacco has played in her culture for centuries.
It's our sign of appreciation because to us, tobacco is a gift.
But for Robbie personally, it's a bad habit. Not the traditional form of tobacco used in ceremonial pipes, but commercial products sold in stores. And Robbie is not alone.
For the American Indian, it's the highest ethnic group. It's 26% smoking prevalence.
Amy Lukowski oversees the nation's largest nonprofit tobacco quitline at National Jewish Health in Denver. While the overall number of smokers is going down, experts here say three groups are lighting up in troubling numbers. In addition to the 26% of American Indians who smoke, 36% of those with mental health issues smoke. And smoking among members of the LGBT community is up to 200% higher than the general population. And one major reason is advertising.
There's a popular ad that says, whenever somebody says, that's gay, we'll be there for you. And it's a tobacco company ad.
Other ads speak directly to American Indians. So that's what experts here are doing too.
Hello, thank you for calling the American Tobacco Quit.
Becoming the first quitline in the nation to pair American Indian callers to counselors who understand the difference between traditional and commercial tobacco use.
What we heard from our focus groups is that people want to work with people that understand what they've been through.
A concept experts here hope to expand in an effort to reach other groups who've been overlooked or underserved.
That same psychological advantage across anything in the world. Your peers are talking to you, you're more willing to listen.
At National Jewish Health in Denver, this is Clark Powell reporting.